All right, first thing I did was wash my hands. Turn the fan off too, we don't want anything blowing. This is a sterile process. If you touch or bump anything, we start over. Scott has nicely provided a garbage for me right there.
There is.
A mask for the patient.
Yeah.
A mask for the nurse. And always get a good seal. We don't want to be breathing on anything. Carefully remove gloves. Carefully. Pick this up. And we're just going to touch the corners. This is our sterile field. Now we are going to carefully, tape can roll, so you got to be careful with the tape. Dump everything there. All right. Dropping, be careful not to let it roll off if you can help it. If it does, you get a new one. These bio patches kind of stick to the package a little bit, so you kind of work your way, kind of hold it like that, and so it kind of unsticks itself. Two sets of sterile gloves. We'll just do that last one. So with the first set, I'm going to get everything squared away, and then take his dressing off. And then with the second set, I'll clean and cover up the dressing. All right. So we've got the bio patch we're going to use. This is a stat lock that holds the catheter in place. This is a little skin prep to help it stick even better. Some Steri-Strips if you need them. The gauze we will not need. We're gonna use the ChloraPrep. It gives you three choices in case they're allergic. We got iodine. Have alcohol. Those you toss aside and you can use them for a first aid kit. So we're gonna, I'll just leave that wrapped up. I am gonna get this prepped and ready to go, which we won't need it till later on in the process. And we'll hook up the saline to that and flush that line so it's all primed and ready to go. Now's the time to do this. Just want to be careful not to pull too hard. It can be tender on the person's skin. Scott has a, looks like another piece of tape.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was coming off.
Sorry about that.
It's okay.
So you want to inform your clients that if the it starts rolling up on the edges, just to tape it down. There's our bio patch. Now here, when you're taking this off, you want to be very careful not to pull too much. We still have the stat lock down here. And like, I'll hold pressure on the stat lock while I'm pulling the dressing away. And then I can hold pressure again. Because we do not want to pull this PICC line out. And it's very easy to get messed up here just because it's so. You know what I'm gonna do, Scott? I'm gonna
get rid of the extender.
Well, I'm just gonna drape it over this way so it's not pulling as much. Now with the stat lock, if it's really in place hard, this one's peeling off real easy. You can use an alcohol swab and put it on the front side of this, and it will loosen the back side. Okay. So now we get rid of the first set of sterile gloves. Again, we make sure there's no fans blowing, no windows open, anything to blow germs on that area, which is now exposed. Now, once we get it cleaned up, the key is letting it dry before putting your clear dressing over the top. Is people that have allergic issues, not really allergic, but issues usually have them when the ChloraPrep doesn't dry enough and then you put the adhesive, there's some sort of reaction that gets kind of itchy. All right, well, three swabs. You want to scrub hard, but you also want to be careful not to dislodge that PICC line. So we start in the middle, closest to that thing, and then kind of work our way out. There. And that was just a piece of tape that was probably on that line.
Yep.
And you got to be careful to, if you want, you can use my arm or your shoulder.
Oh, can I do this?
Yeah, you can do that. You just want to keep your shirt away from it.
Oh, yeah.
And this is the skin prep for the stat lock. Looks like it's going to go right about here. Tape measure, I'm just going to measure the length of the catheter. Six centimeters. We'll measure his arm later with that. Still looking a little tacky. Arm doing all right?
Mm-hmm.
If you forget about the trick I told you, it says right on here, remove with alcohol. But Scott's came right off, so. Now with this stat lock, I like to lock it down beforehand, that way I'm not pressing on Scott's arm, and
you're gonna do this thing?
Oh, yep, the bio patch. Thank you, Scott.
A lot of pressure right now.
And this says this side up, so you just gotta read the instructions. Slip that right in there. All right, at this point, we are all covered up so we can get rid of our mask, which is a little warm today, huh?
A little bit.
All right, just want to be careful, make sure it's a good seal. There are a couple little things on this piece of paper we're going to use. One is a date stamp. We'll sign and date. The other is a little, I don't know if they call it a bow tie or what, but it's a little reinforcement here. And I usually get Scott's assistant to,
pull the line up.
Yeah. You can just have it dangle and I can. Okay, perfect. Look at that, multitasking. And again, that just seals it up a little bit better. Some people will also tape it a little more. And then we have a date one. We need the date. Date it and initial it. So the next person knows when it was last changed. Scott, do you want a couple?
At the top is good. That's where it always comes first, comes off first.
Shoot, I threw that thing away. I could have used that.
Oh, that's all right. That'll work.
You're good there. Well, we're gonna draw labs and then we'll change out the extension. All right, so this is all clean yet. Just gotta make sure not to touch anything. Flush the right end.
It works a little better, right?
It does. Twist and lock is, clamp is open. So that is all primed and ready to go. We'll draw labs first and then again, this is, we're done with the sterile part of it, so we just need regular old gloves. All right, open the clamp. This is our waist. Just gonna flush this and then we'll just heparinize that last nice hands-free device. Not hands-free, but don't have to worry about getting
cold. Yeah, they're vacuumed, right?
Yep. Always check your expiration on your tubes, because that's something to easily overlook. Invert 10 times. Or so. Alright, so these are ready. What was the trick you told me about this?
Oh, push the plunger first before you open it. You go past that little click.
Yep.
And then it'll come out really easy when you're trying to get rid of the air.
All right.
Otherwise, it has that resistance and then it's flying out.
No, I already primed this with saline, so I'm going to have to waste a little more. All right, that should be good. Clamp is on. I actually had to use a pair of pliers on those ones.
Oh, I know. They made one for a while. They had like a lock that nobody could get off. It like yanking and yanking or twisting.
What is that? Is that a piece,
piece of tape
that came off?
I think it might be closed there still, right?
Oh, maybe that was one I sat there for when I was...
I think that's closed still.
No, I just closed it.
Oh.
Yeah, it won't go if it's... If
right.
It's, and we need an orange cap. All right, very good. Do you have a new sock?
Yeah, I think it's in the kit, right?
Oh, it's over here.
No, I thought it was saw it. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, turn it off, Bridge.